Alright, what's up everyone? Duquesne23 here, and Ubisoft invited me to try out Riders Republic behind closed doors, over the internet, of course. But we got to try out Riders Republic, and it was so much fun. This game I've been following for a little while, whenever I first saw the trailer for it. And it's just one of those games where, you know, it's kind of like Descenders. If you haven't played Descenders, I loved playing that game. I streamed it all the time. And I love just the aspect of going downhill on your mountain bike and doing crazy jumps and tricks and everything like that. But of course, Riders Republic takes it to the next level. They include, you know, different like snowboarding and skiing. They have the mountain bikes type of thing. They have like crazy stuff like these jet bikes and, you know, just other like these jet skis. And like not jet skis that go on the water, but skis that have little rockets on the back of them that make you go really fast. It's insane. And then also pretty much like a jetpack type of wingsuit thing where you actually get to go flying through the air. And there's a whole bunch of other stuff and everything that, you know, I wasn't able to try because this is a, you know, little beta, like pre-showing of the actual game. And so the full game is going to have a lot more content, but I had a blast in this game, from just doing the normal races to versus mode, to finding some things like different landmarks and this other things called relics. And then of course the most fun and the thing that I think most people will be excited to be able to play is called the mass race events. And these things are crazy. It starts out with 32 people and you're having fun and you're racing down, you know, the mountain for the first at the beginning. Now you don't have collision for the first little bit, so that way everyone's just not slamming into each other from the start. But after like the first 7 to 10 seconds or something like that, collision turns on, and so then you can start bumping people into trees and everything like that. It gets so chaotic and so crazy. And it is just so much fun. Like this game, I was having a blast playing it. So Ubisoft, thank you so much for inviting me out to this. Like this was unbelievable to be able to do. If you do want to check out more gameplay of just raw gameplay, not me just talking over it or anything like that, because I'm not going to flood that over here on this channel. Be sure to go check out my other channel. I'll link it in the description to that. I will have a bunch of raw gameplay going up on there. Where you can just, you know, it's edited down, but it's not going to have me just talking over it the entire time. So you can just enjoy just the gameplay, hearing the sounds, hearing the, you know, ambient noises of everything, the animals and stuff like that. Like, this game is beautiful, and this is just a early version of the game. It still has some issues, of course, with it. Any game, you know, that you're playing early is going to have some problems. But, you know, there's still some issues, but it was still a blast to play. I can see myself streaming this and playing this with other, you know, people just all the time. And it is cross-platform play, so that's another great thing. So it doesn't matter where you're playing, your friends can jump in and play with you. This was just a blast to be able to play. So I highly suggest going to check out more footage of this if you haven't already. I will leave a link to my other channel in the description down below. I will most likely be coming out with another video of this, just kind of going over the mass races, because it was insane. Like, the mass races were just so much fun. There's actually one of them I got fourth place on. I could have gotten better, but I made some mistakes and I ran into the ground and some trees. Don't worry about that. But it was just a blast to be able to play. So, you know, this is a game I definitely, you know, want to tell people, keep an eye out. I had so much fun playing this, so please keep an eye out for this. It is also really fun to be able to play first person. That's why you notice a lot of my gameplay is in first person. It's just that that's what I really enjoy, getting that really immersed feeling of going in there and, you know, just seeing like the front handlebars of your bike or just anything like that. Like, you know, it's just more immersive and I enjoy it a lot more. In racing games, I like going into cockpit view in racing games just because it feels more immersive. So I'm really happy they added that onto here. Now, I do hope they will add, because whenever you do tricks in first person, it pulls you out into third person while you're doing the trick. So I do hope they add the option to be able to go and stay in first person in tricks. So that way, if you want to be able to do your tricks like backflips and just anything like that, But while in first person, I would love to be able to do that just to, you know, give you that more immersion into the game and everything. So this game was so much fun to be able to play. There's so many different areas you can go to. There's, you know, all the, you know, like different areas around the U.S. that are real, you know, popular, like Yosemite, you know, there you have Half Dome that you can go over to. And, you know, like there's just other places, you know, that you can go over to. Like, it's just the fact that they have this entire huge area and it's populated with people. Now, not everyone you will see is an actual like person going and everything, like, but those aren't AI either. Those are just pretty much like, I forget how they explained it exactly, but it's basically like a recording kind of what they did. So, you know, while they're racing, those were actually where people were racing and how they raced and everything like that. None of this is just, you know, the NPCs running down the hills or things like that. Those are just people of their past races or just them doing free roam and stuff like that. Just, you know, roaming around and everything. And it is awesome just to be able to see that many people. And it just kind of fills out the world, makes it doesn't seem like it's barren, because that's one thing about a lot of games. You know, that are like snowboarding games or, you know, bike games or things like that. It feels a little bit barren. It feels like you're the only one on the mountain, which can feel cool. That's cool sometimes. But then most of the time, like, I love seeing all the community and all the people racing and everything on the game. So this game was a blast to be able to play. I know I keep saying that, but it honestly, I want this to get on people's radar more than what it is. It's not just because I was invited by Ubisoft to be able to check this out. No, they, you know, I didn't have to say all this great stuff about it. If I didn't like it, then I could say I didn't like it. But I had so much fun with this. There's an obstacle course at the main little hub spot where you could sit there and go through all the different obstacles on there, and it gets difficult. Like, it doesn't seem too hard whenever you're just going up to it, but to actually balance your bike on like a log, or, you know, in the log, like, curves and stuff, or, like, these boards. There's one at the very end that got me, you know, very, like, it pretty much got me a lot, was where there's this, like, boards going out, and you're pretty high up, and then there's a gap. So you have to jump your bike, you have to ollie your bike, and you have to go over, or bunny hop, not ollie, bunny hop your bike over this little gap and land on another tiny little, you know, board on the other side, and then keep balancing it. Oh my gosh, it was, that got me, I finally finished though the obstacle course, but that got me, so many times I failed on that, where I had like a minute and a half left on the time on this obstacle course, and I just kept failing on that one part over and over and over, and I couldn't finish it. Like, there's just so much stuff, and there's these obstacle courses, you know, there's more of them around everywhere. And the same thing with these mass races, like, you know, the mass races happen, I'm trying to remember what they said. I think every 15 minutes, something like that. You know, so you can just basically keep hopping into mass race after mass race if you wanted to. And just doing a whole bunch of different mass races. And it's just so much fun. Like, I cannot wait for this game to release and be able to play with people. This just was a blast to be able to play. I have tons of footage for it, so you will be seeing more. I will make a few more videos over it on this channel. Where I'm talking about certain aspects of the game. But then also, if you want to just see the raw gameplay footage, I highly suggest going to my second channel. And I have some raw footage over there that y'all can check out. So, thank you everyone for coming out. This was so much fun, Ubisoft. So, thank you for inviting me out to this. I appreciate it more than y'all know. It was awesome to be able to check out. So, I will see y'all in the next video, and be sure to just keep an eye out on Riders Republic, and just keep an eye out on the game. It is a blast to be able to play, and if you love games like this where it's just racing and has a lot of community aspects of it, and you can have a lot of fun going with different things, like, it's not just, oh, I'm just going to ride my BMX bike, or I'm just going to ride my mountain bike, I'm just going to ride, you know, my snowboard, you know, like, type of game. Like, no, this has everything in it, and it is so much fun. There's huge jumps, there's crazy tricks. Like, it's just a blast to be able to play. So, highly suggest checking it out, and I guess that will be it, and I will see y'all in the next video.
Chopping it up! You're top three at the minute! midpoint.